Yes, we are live. Welcome everybody to this beautiful Monday, June 8th. Michael Lafito here. Welcome back to our 26th episode of the Luxury Listing Specialist program. We launched this on April 10th due to COVID-19, and I'm actually shooting this from our new office. I've been in the same office for over 5.5 years, and we just literally switched. So I'm shooting this from my laptop as our desktop. We're getting all connected. And I'm really excited. From time to time, we have various guests from various organizations. And I have with me today Jeff Berger. He's the founder and CEO of NAGLREP, which is the National Association of Gay, Lesbian, Real Estate Professionals. And being Pride Month, I thought what better time to have Jeff on. And I know I can learn a lot, Jeff. So welcome.
Thank you so much, Michael. It's a pleasure to be here. And happy Pride Month.
Happy Pride Month. Appreciate your time today. And talk to me a little bit about, Jeff, when you founded NAGLREP and what year was that, and kind of what went into it. I mentioned to you offline, but last year I spoke at NAGLREP, the National Association National Association of Real Estate Brokers, which is an African American based organization, and blacks weren't allowed in NAR 70 something years ago. That's how they launched. So I'd love to hear a little bit about how you launched and when you launched.
Thank you, Michael. First, thanks for your interest in NAGLREP. It's always an honor to know that someone is an ally to the LGBT community, especially in real estate. And when we talk about NAGLREP, well, you know, I met them through the National Association of Realtors Diversity Program. Professionals just with one thing in mind, increasing homeownership for the African-American community. And in 2007, I looked at organizations like NAGLREP, like NAREP, the Hispanic group, like ORIA, the Asian group. And I said, you know, there's a void here. The LGBT community isn't represented with one of these groups. And that was it. I went to work. I formed the National Association of Gay and Lesbian Real Estate Professionals. One of our greatest achievements, I believe personally, in my opinion, is we brought forward to the National Association of Realtors the proposal to include sexual orientation and gender identity to the NAR Code of Ethics, Article 10. So, you know, that was a long process and it took many, many years. It went from 2008 to 2013 by the time we were done with both sexual orientation and gender identity. But, you know, it was from the Diversity Committee of the National Association of Realtors, and primarily it's composed of persons from NAREB, NAREP, and ORIA. With all of our support and collaborations, we were able to push it through with the other realtor associations, because you need a realtor association to actually put forth the proposal. And we worked with, for example, the Wisconsin Realtor Association. And I'll tell you some great history. At the time that we worked with the Wisconsin Realtor Associations, the president was Bill Macasian.
Okay.
And he is now president of advocacy for all of the National Association of Realtors. And he retires this year. So it's a great legacy that he left behind. And he's just a fantastic man. What he's done for all of diversity in real estate and to increase home ownership for all, you know, it's just something I would like to, you know, recognize here as he is retiring this year.
That's great. Yeah, I spoke at the Wisconsin Association of Realtors annual conference probably about 4 years ago up in,
Madison?
It was just outside of Madison, where all the watered parks are, and I'm drawing a blank here, but it was a great time. I brought my kids and my family up there, and we had a blast. Wisconsin Dells, it was just outside of Wisconsin Dells at the Kalahari Resort. So it was well attended, and, you know, I'm based in Chicago and Chicagoland, and, you know, we talk a lot about real estate, and we're talking about luxury, and I can't confirm this exact statistic, but I've recently heard that in Illinois, there's over 600 various pensions. And that's part of what's driving a lot of people outside of the state of Illinois because taxes are going up. And in Wisconsin, they only have three forms of pensions and Illinois has over 600. So I digress, but I wanted to share that since we were talking about Wisconsin. So you said 2008 to about 2013, five painstaking years, a lot of time, a lot of energy to put into this.
Yes, you know, we just forged ahead, you know, when you're up, you know, it's like anything. You wake up in the morning and you got your list of things to do. And we just kept on checking our list and checking our list. And, you know, we worked a lot. You know, and, you know, if something is worth attaining, you know, you're going to have to get up and go for it. So, you know, it was never a barrier ever to our group. We just kept on pushing forward and here we are.
So when did you formally, NAGLREP formally kind of form? What year was that approximately?
I started NAGLREP in 2007.
Seven, okay.
Yeah, from my home office.
Okay.
Yeah.
And fast forward to today, approximately how many, not holding you to the exact number, of course, but approximately how many members there are and what does it comprise? What does membership look like from agent to lender? You know, talk to me about that if you would.
Sure. So there are 2,800 members of NAGLREP at the present time, a little more give or take. And they comprise of realtors, real estate agents, mortgage professionals, title services professionals. You know, it's really a wide range, you know, including home inspectors, appraisers, you know.
Okay.
And I think what's really important to note is that in addition to our diverse professions, we are diverse in our organization, whereas, you know, 10% of our membership identify themselves as allies. So one of the misconceptions of, you know, becoming a NAGLREP member is you have to identify as LGBT. And the answer to that is no.
Good to know. That's good to know. And you guys have an annual conference as well, correct?
Correct. We host a national conference each fall. This year, the date is October 6th to the 8th in Palm Springs, California. You know, as of now, the event is still planned, and we are accepting registrations on the event website. However, we have told our membership to hold off for registering for now because California is just opening. We're kind of erring on the cautious side.
Sure.
And we don't know what it's going to look like. You know, they're first entering stage one of opening California, then stage two. By the time October rolls around, you know, we don't know what social distancing is going to look like. You know, our events host approximately 600 attendees.
Jeez.
And, you know, that's not going to happen.
Yeah.
You know, it may not be deemed safe, and we're just going to follow, you know, the rules of the land. And, you know, we'll announce at the end of June, by the way.
So okay.
We're going to follow what's happening with the state of California and rolling out their, you know, opening up campaign.
Sure.
So
yeah, I have a feeling a lot of states will, I could be wrong on this, but I have a feeling just after the 4th of July is when, you know, a lot of these states are going to reevaluate what phase they're on. I think purposely they might want to hold some people back from large gatherings with that big holiday. But I could be wrong on that. That's just my guess.
Well, I think your intuition is right. I agree. So time will tell.
Yeah. So thank you for that information. As far as... So you have an annual event. If somebody is a member, is there like a private Facebook group or other, you know, Rolodex? Talk to us a little bit about membership benefits. You don't have to go into too many details, but more bullet point if you want.
Yeah, I think what's really exciting about NAGLREP is, you know, in addition to being a national trade organization, which does include 42 local chapters now, that are engaged with local realtor associations. Like, for example, we do a lot of lunch and learns. But, you know, more than that, you know, which really differentiates us from the other diverse organizations is NAGLREP has a consumer-facing website. So, you know, when we talk about the LGBT community, you know, often we discuss, you know, things that are really important to increasing LGBT homeownership. If we just talk about, you know, the buying trends, well, that's great. That's really important. But
sure.
What is it, what more is there that's holding back the rate of LGBT homeownership? Because LGBT homeownership right now is estimated by Freddie Mac research to be approximately 49%. Whereas the national average is 65%.
Mm.
So, you know, that's a wide gap. Okay. So with that being said, let's talk about the benefits. So because of discrimination, which we feel is a main, you know, reason for that gap, the LGBT community is very often searching online for a LGBT or allied realtor or real estate professional. And since 2007, I'm doing all the SEO for NAGLREP.com, which is our website. So when a consumer is searching for a home, you know, of course the home, the bedrooms, everything is so important, the kitchen, but then when they go to search for a home, they need that LGBT or allied agent to help them, you know? And I think that's the differentiator. So what they're doing is most often they're searching online on Google for LGBT real estate, gay realtor, gay real estate, lesbian real estate, LGBT realtor. I mean, you name it, I've covered all the bases. And NAGLREP.com receives on average 75,000 unique visits per month from LGBT home buyers and sellers. So what's really, really important to know is the business opportunity. So when you join NAGLREP, right after you join, the thank you page brings you to our user-friendly profile builder. You enter your profile into our website and you add all the cities that you service. So I live in Jupiter, Florida. If I'm joining, I join, I start building my profile, upload my photo, my logo, my company address, the 16 cities I serve, link to my website, yada, yada, yada.
Mm-hmm.
And immediately I'm on the site, I'm searchable. So someone comes to the site, they search Jupiter, Florida, I pop up along with all the other members, okay, that also service Jupiter, Florida.
Okay.
Now here's where it's really important, okay? And you see the business opportunity, because we poll our members each year and we create the LGBT real estate report, which is downloadable on our homepage if you wanted to know more about the data about, you know, trends in the LGBT real estate world. And when we polled our members through SurveyMonkey, we had a great ratio of 33% of our membership answering our survey. That's a really high ratio.
Yeah, that's a great return.
Yeah, and members said that from the directory, they're receiving on average 1 to 3 consumer transactions per year from NAGLREP.com. Okay?
That pays for membership like 10, 20 to 1.
Correct. Okay, so let's do the numbers, okay? So you've got 2,800 members. You've got, let's use a denominator of 1.3, for example, 1.3 deals per year.
Okay.
Okay. Comes out to about 38 to 3,900 deals, which are procured through NAGLREP.com per year. Okay, maybe more. If you multiply that by the median home price of $270,000, that's $1 billion in gross sales. Billion with a B. And then when you look at the GCI, you're looking at about $50 million GCI just procured from NAGLREP.com. So, you know, we call it a win-win. So, you know, what we do is we serve the LGBT community to help them buy a home and to increase LGBT home ownership, because without that LGBT friendly realtor, you know, you may not find your safe space. So if we can serve the consumer, and as professionals, we earn a good livelihood, well, hey, isn't that what real estate's all about?
Win-win.
Yeah. So talk about benefits, you know, and then there's all the other things like, you know, attend our events. We also do advocacy. We're raising awareness for the Equality Act now. which would add sexual orientation and gender identity to the federal fair housing law. You know, we're advocating with that. We're engaged with the LGBT Congressional Equality Caucus.
So and we also,
go ahead.
I have a question about the fair housing law. So somebody right now, talk to me about discrimination like that. That it's not a protected class.
Yeah, that's a great question. So, you know, NAGLREP worked, as I spoke earlier, to amend the NAR Code of Ethics. So
right.
It is a protected class in the realtor world.
In the realtor world.
Correct. There's a difference. Okay.
Yeah.
So, you know, there are a lot of real estate agents that aren't realtors and the Code of Ethics doesn't apply to them. You know, we can educate and we could do everything we want to and try to do, you know, for the goodness of, you know, a healthy housing market. But, you know, there's only so much you can do. You know, I always have a saying that, you know, it's a morality question. Okay. You know, and my thought is, you know, and this is like off topic, but you know, it's just an analogy. You know, the reason why people don't rob banks is not because of morality. It's because they don't want to go to prison. Okay. So if someone doesn't have a law, you know, that is, you know, telling them that they have to be, you know, fair to people, well, you know, I think a majority of the people will be fair, but there will be always some that just say, you know what? I don't feel that those people have the same rights as me, you know, and that's what federal law, you know, that's where federal law would really make the difference. So, you know, excuse me for, you know,
no, please,
an analogy that, you know, may be off base, but, you know, I just wanted to paint the picture because, you know, we have to understand that, you know, whether it's, you know, discrimination of any kind, you know, this is housing we're talking about, you know, whether it's housing, employment, I mean, any discrimination of any kind is just, you know, not acceptable.
Yeah, that for sure. And Jeff, that's one of my goals, of course, of having you on today is for our audience. We stream to various groups as well as the replays. And, you know, we want to get as much information out there about NAGLREP and how agents, you know, can learn more, educate more, you know, raise the bar in the industry and as well as, you know, for the consumers.
Thank you. Thank you.
So you mentioned on average 2,800 agents or members, I should say, and 1.3 is the denominator. You know, if an agent joins and they get a referral from there, is there? I did research, so I know the answer. But is there a referral fee involved? You know, in our industry, referral fees are common, right? So, like Dave Ramsey's got, he's a radio host and endorsed real estate agents, and if they send you a referral, you got to pay them a referral fee. But with NAGLREP, that's not the case, correct?
That is correct. There is never a referral fee. Never, ever. The one caveat to that is, you know, NAGLREP never charges a referral fee, but, you know, what's also important is in addition to the consumers, the members are so actively referring one another. We built up a rapport from from attending the conference over the years. From just, you know, a member in Chicago's, you know, their customer may be relocating to Naples, Florida, for example. He
sure.
says, who can I recommend? You know, let me go to the NAGLREP database, you know, let me search, and they find, you know, ABC member of NAGLREP, say, oh, I think that would be a great fit. He has nice reviews or she has nice reviews. And we seem to have some things in common because the profiles are dynamic with reviews, with, you know, professional achievements, a bio, et cetera, et cetera. You know, if the realtor referred that other, if the member referred another member, it is common in the industry that they
sure.
would request a referral fee.
Yeah.
So, you know, but, you know.
But in that instance, it would be, you know, broker to broker, not NAGLREP receiving a referral fee.
That's exactly correct. And NAGLREP isn't even involved in the communication. We don't get CC'd on any emails. We're absolutely, you know, just a digital, you know, source.
Yeah, that's great. Well, What other information, Jeff, would you like to share that maybe our audience, and again, vast audience, newer agents, veteran agents, boutique or with a franchise, you know, what's maybe a way that agents could get involved or find out more about NAGLREP and be an advocate?
Yeah, great question. You know, being Pride Month, it's just a great time to show your colors. You know, we have a color, we have a campaign right now called True Colors. And, you know, go to NAGLREP.com. You know, what I would really recommend you do also is, you know, I'm always, you know, impartial, I'm biased. You know, do a Google search. You know, think about where the LGBT consumer is that's looking for that safe space. And, you know, think about where they are in their mindset. You know, are they on Google? Are they searching for LGBT real estate, LGBT realtor, gay realtor, lesbian realtor? And do those searches and you'll find NAGLREP.com. And click over. You know, we're at the top. I do all the SEO. And, you know, find out more about us. You know, download the LGBT real estate report on our homepage. You know, a great growth market is be an ally. You know, a lot of people, you know, think, oh, well, you know, that's not for me. I'm not gay. I'm not lesbian. I'm not bisexual. I'm not transgender, you know, which is the acronym LGBT. But you would be amazed at, you know, how friendly and how grateful the LGBT community is for allies. Because here's something to think about, okay? And it's really important, and I think it's a sign of the times and something important that we all, you know, talk about. You know, the LGBT community is still a minority. You know, the LGBT community is approximately 4 to 6% of the entire population in the United States. Some people will say it's up to 7 or 8, you know, but statistics say 4 to 6. So if the LGBT community wants to ever win a vote or, you know, advance LGBT rights, we can't do it alone. We need allies because we don't have the numbers. So, you know, that's something that a great LGBT advocate taught me that spoke at our conference. Hmm. You know, you have to bridge the gap. You know, you can't be closed-minded. You have to win a larger community than just the LGBT community because, you know, if you ever want to, you know, influence a large group of people, you know, it's looking at a macro, you know, what I call definition, because I think macro when I think of things, you know, I think long-term, I look to what the end of the tunnel is before I even look to entering the door. Mm-hmm. And you know, for me, you know, I grew up in New York. I consider myself like a street guy. A lot of people don't know that about me. You know, I used to work on Wall Street. You know, they said, if you want a friend, get a dog. You know, the first day I started, you know, and I'll tell you, I'm sorry, I put that into voicemail.
Oh, you're
you know,
fine.
What I love about real estate, okay, just digressing, and why I got out of Wall Street is, you know, what I love about real estate is the people, most of them at least, you know, a lot of egos in this industry, but that's okay.
Yeah, there are.
I'm okay with that. I know who my people are. But what I love about real estate, you know, in particular is that you get to, you know, inspect the property before it's bought. And I think so many investors in the stock market sometimes don't know, you know, the financials, you know, and I think that's a concern. Like you look at the, well, there's just so much to talk about, you know, from the Glass-Steagall Act and so much changes that happened since I was on Wall Street, you know. And, you know, I think that's what I love about real estate, you know, that it's very transparent and, you know, you just have a market where you come in with a home inspector, you know, you're not going to have a surprise quarter, you know, if you buy a home and, you know, 3 months later, one quarter later, the, you know, the home value goes down, you still have a home to live in, you know, on Wall Street, if you buy a stock and it has a terrible quarter or, you know, something drastic happened, you know, you can sometimes lose all your money.
Yeah.
And then you can be able to afford your mortgage and not have a home. So, you know, they say you know, the way to make a small fortune on Wall Street is start with a big fortune.
I've never heard that, but.
Yeah, they say a lot of things, but, you know, sorry to digress, you know, I'm just kind of telling you a little bit about, you know, where I'm coming from and my view on real estate and, you know, who we are as professionals and, you know, I think this industry is one of good ethics, and I'm impressed every day. You know, it's the bad stories that sometimes get press, but you know, overall, I'm impressed with all the support the LGBT community gets.
That's great to hear, Jeff. That's great to hear.
You know, if we talk about discrimination, you know, a couple of bad apples aren't going to spoil our bunch in the real estate community. You know, and going back to the Newsday story that happened this year, you know, still, a couple of bad apples aren't going to spoil us. We're a great industry, and we're always going to thrive.
I love your optimism, and, you know, that could be said for a lot of various industries, but being optimistic, right, focusing on the good versus the negative, so that's really refreshing.
Thank you. A pleasure.
You're welcome. Looking real quick, I'm looking at my phone. If anybody has any questions for Jeff, let me know. Terry Sprigg. Hi, Terry. He's a top luxury agent on the West Coast. He goes, how do I join? Is there a fee, referral fee? So go to naglrep.com, and there's an annual fee for agents, just under $200, I saw, right?
There's a first-year introductory rate of $149.
Okay.
Yeah. What company is he with?
So he's a Christie's affiliate. He's an independent called Lux. They do some really, he does some really cool stuff. You'll like Terry.
Great. So just go to the website and click join, and all the information's there.
Yeah. Yeah. Terry, I looked at it ahead of time. It's really simple. Scroll down. Pretty self-explanatory. Very nice website, by the way.
Thank you.
Yeah. I bet
Thank you very
it's
much.
Taken a lot of revisions and years to kind of get it to where it's at.
Yeah, I designed it myself
with a designer. Okay.
With a designer. And, you know, they say these years you got to Fisher Price stuff. You know, people want, you know, what they want quick and simple. And, you know, that was our goal, you know, to really just make it simple as, you know, anyone just jumping on could really understand everything really quick.
Yeah. No, absolutely. We just launched our websites for my speaking and consulting site about 8 months ago, and it took us a long time, so I can appreciate where you're coming from there. Any other questions? I don't see any other questions. So Jeff, what's the best way if somebody wants to get a hold of you? You know, is it through social media, an email address? What's the best way?
Yeah, email is preferred. My email is Berger, B-E-R-G-E-R, at naglrep.com.
Okay.
Sorry, I'm in my backyard and the gardeners are here, so maybe there's some background noise.
Oh, you're fine.
Yeah. So once again, it's jberger@naglrep.com.
Perfect. And we'll type that in as well for everybody that's watching, and we'll get a copy of this, Jeff, to you. So thank you for your time today.
An absolute pleasure. Thank you for your time as well. And we look forward to sharing this on our social media channels. And please share it with me when you have a moment.
Yeah, we certainly will. We'll get this over to you today. And so it's Pride Month. And so I thought it would be perfect. I could learn. I learned from you. And I'll be joining as well to support your cause. So appreciate everything you're doing. Yeah. You're welcome. So today was our 26th live Luxury Lunch and Learn. Wednesday will be our 27th live. And then we're doing the Griswold West Coast trip. So we're going to take a couple weeks off, and then we'll circle back at the end of the month. But if you guys have any questions for me, chime in below or shoot me an email, michael@marketingluxurygroup.com, michael@marketingluxurygroup. Wednesday's guest, you're going to enjoy. We're going to be talking about print mail, where a lot of real estate agents are getting away from print or all going digital, but you're going to like Alvin. He's going to be sharing with us best strategies if you want to do some farming. So have a great Monday, guys. Jeff, thanks again for your time. Make it a great day, and we'll talk to everybody soon. Bye for now.